Let's pay homage to the lineage gurus, homage to the Venerable Monk Liao Ming, homage to Master Sakya Zhengkong, homage to His Holiness the 16th Kamapa, and homage to Master Dubten Dorji, homage to the three jewels of the altar, homage to the main deity of the group practice this evening, the medicine Tathagata Sunmo, Tanzan Gatso, Dutan City, all Dharma masters, Dharma educators, Dharma teachers, Dharma instructors, Dharma tutors, temple and center directors, and all disciples present here and over the internet. Good evening, how do you do?
新照甘恩愛してる愛してるシャナゲオラミコオラミコケケロムチョすごい一番気持ちいい準備準備ヤビ Bling bling. Konbanwa.
For the medicine Tathagata. Our wish, because medicine Tathagata has many vows.
要是琉璃光如来呢, 就是希望众生的病,
so medicine Buddha wish that illnesses of sentient beings can be alleviated. And nowadays, illnesses are not just of the body, but also of the mind, or emotionally, mentally, psychologically, and there are more and more strange illnesses. Like today, the illness that I saw at the Truebuddha Foundation, the illness that a disciple got, spine, something I've never heard of, like it's a, what's that, emptied? Is there such a illness? There are so many strange symptoms and illnesses. Nowadays they exist. Syringomyelia? Syringomyelia, I don't know. So there are more and more all kinds of illnesses, and you can have medicine for the illnesses of the body, but illnesses of the mind, we would not know how to cure that. So we hope that medicine Tathagata can bless sentient beings so they attain peace and ease and happiness. So sentient beings can abandon sufferings, because being sick is a true suffering. Like this time, the 3-year pandemic, Ever since I was born until now, almost 80 years, I have never encountered this kind of pandemic before. I never encountered something like that before. And in the very beginning, when I drove to the Leizang Temple to have meals, there was no car at all on the roads. And the rule in America is if you're only allowed to go to the hospital or to ship things and nothing else, so just hospital, or when you're out of food, you can shop for some food that's allowed. And then to the post office to send things, and nothing else. So nobody's around, nobody's on the roads. If I were to be stopped by the police officer, I would ask, is it okay for me to have food, to have meals? That's what I thought then. Nobody was anywhere. So the thieves suffered. You know why? Because everybody's at home. Everybody's home. So, these 3 years, just like that, time flies, 3 years.
So,
it's rarely encountered in my life. It's my first time. And until now, COVID-19 is still around, right? I heard that you will, if you get infected, you will get brain fog. But being vaccinated without being, even if you don't get infected, but just the immunization, the vaccines give you brain fog too. And recently, I feel that way too. My memory is gone. I remember things from my childhood, but not things that just happened. Or things that I just did, I forgot. Like making an offering, like every day. And then I lift the plate and I chanted, and then I put it down, and then I asked people around, but did I make the offering earlier?
You just
lifted the plate and made the offering, and then you asked. So those kind of things happened. And brain fog is a scary thing. Someone went to Hong Kong on a half a month trip and came home.
And
asked him, where have you been in Hong Kong?
Huh?
Did I go to Hong Kong?
And
he's forgotten his trip to Hong Kong completely. So strange. We went on the same trip and we still remembered going where and what. But he somehow completely erase that period in Hong Kong. It's become completely blank, so such a symptom also happens. And today I saw a letter. A graceful girl
or lady. And
she went to another place for school. After coming home, she changed completely from before. There's a story about it, but that's how she is until now. That her soul that flew out. Most Taoist practitioners would say that we have two different kinds of souls, hun and po. And if you lose one of the parts of the soul, then you need to find it back and make it return to the body, then you will become a normal person again. Otherwise, you as if you are in a daze, as if you are missing something, you have no heart or mind. She has no purpose, no goal in her life. She doesn't know what to do. It's quite pitiful. So I hope that Medicine Tathagata bless everybody so that they gain health, good health, and also healthy mentally and psychologically, emotionally. Today, we had a little girl having her birthday. Marichi. Where is Marichi?
Oh, Minhui. You're
part of the AV team?
是的，师尊。啊，今天是你的生日啊。
Is today your birthday? Yes.
要不要唱歌给你听？
Should I sing a song for you?
是妈妈，我难当。We
wish you a happy birthday。是妈妈，搬家屋。 We pray for your longevity. May you be safe, healthy, and prosperous. We wish you a happy long life.
Happy birthday.
谢谢师尊。
Happy birthday in Indonesian. Selamat ulang tahun. Happy birthday. Okay, this is my little gift for you. This is very cute. When she was very little,
很小,
I hug her.
And
carried her. Now she's 19. I cannot hug her anymore. So she's an adult now. When she was little, she's also one that I hug.
人家都那么大了,
she's grown up, and I've grown old.
想一想,
so thinking about it, time really flies.
以前的小朋友都很小, 每一个都很小,
you know, all the little kids were all small in the past. They were three girls, Li Qian, Li Qi, and Yi Ting. There were three little girls before, standing up very tiny. Now they have all grown up. Look at Li Qi or Kelly. She's having a boyfriend now. And she wears like that. The abbot at the Leizang Temple. How can she dress like that to go to the temple? And I said, that's just a little kid. She's still a little kid, just tolerated. But she's grown up too. And eating. I used to hold her hand every day. No, I don't dare anymore. Everything has changed. Grandmaster too has changed. And now Grandmaster is looking for a smaller girl.
But
there's no little girls around now.
Minghui
or Marichi, she should be very diligent in her schooling. And she used to take care of the camera before as part of the AV team. She's a very good girl. She would never become Li Qi
or Kelly.
Oh, but I'm not saying that Kelly is
not
a good girl or disobedient. And she's very very popular on the internet. And that's how it is. If you're on the internet, then you know, very famous on the internet, and she wanted to be an entertainer. So that's how it is. So otherwise, how can she become famous or popular celebrity, right? She's an internet celebrity now. Let me share a joke.
有一个年轻人,
a young man
seek
advice from a great master.
大师啊,
Master,
怎样才能够结束单身?
How should I end my single life? He's been single.
大师啊,
and the master used his finger to point to the mountain across. And the young man asked, oh, are you saying that in that mountain there was another great master that can provide the answer? And the master said, oh, back then, nobody wanted me, so I became a master here. And you ask the question, so I'm telling you that there is no master in the mountain across, so you can go there to become a monk and then become a great master right away.
没有和尚住, 这个山已经有和尚住,
so in this mountain there's already him, the master, and then but the mountain across there's nobody there. So in the future,
大家都出家,
all the single people should become ordained. After watching a movie, it's rather cold outside.
这个男生呢,
a couple of lovers
给女生披上,
took off his, the man took off his jacket and to ask the woman to wear it. But she took it off right away and no, 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 you wear it.
啊, 这个男生呢,
and the man drip it upon the woman again, and the woman took it off again,
and
let the man wear it.
啊, 后面
and back and forth several times.
单身的人看了,
and the single man behind them felt really touched. What a romantic lover. The man took off his jacket and let her wear it, and back and forth and back and forth. He was very touched. And then suddenly he heard the woman said, why don't you just wear it? How can I wear your clothes going home? How can I explain it to my husband?
Oh, this is a Chinese joke.
This is a Chinese joke. Yeah, this is hard.
It's a
war movie about the old times. And after watching, the wife said, oh, look at all those people are very chauvinistic and narcissistic. And the husband couldn't understand why. But see, all those men went to wars and yet they're holding a banner and with the character, the Chinese character that means handsome. That, but the character also means commander-in-chief. So that's the banner to indicate the commander. And the wife is uneducated and thought it only means handsome.
马来西亚,
now on to the main subject. From Malaysia.
弟子想请问师尊,
Grandmaster,
is with you.
If people fall into the bardo state,
持咒念佛的念珠,
and may I use the mala beads that have been used for chanting a lot to to put on the deceased so that they can receive the light blessings of the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas and then to be reborn into the Pure Land. Thank you for your advice. May you stay in samsara and turn the Dharma wheel. So what he meant is he used this mala beads to chant and then the deceased person would like to put this on his on the deceased's neck or just by his side, so that with this good affinity he can be reborn in the Pure Land.
那我的回答是这样子, 当然可以,
my answer is of course.
当然可以, 啊, 最好的方法呢,
And the best method is not just using mala beads to hang on the deceased neck, but you continually chant the Buddha's name and dedicate the merit to him, to the deceased. Or you chant the deliverance mantra. We have two deliverance or rebirth mantras. So you can chant this rebirth mantra and dedicate the merit to the deceased.
Or
in front of the deceased person, you can also chant Manjushri rebirth mantra.
Om Manjushri Om Abe La Hom Kanchana Soha.
So Manjushri's rebirth mantra and Amitabha rebirth mantra are very powerful, and we should normally chant more of them. And you chant them and dedicate the merit to the deceased person. And then he would be able to attain, to receive this good affinity. So it's allowed to hang the mala beads on his neck or place it next to his body. So you should also chant more of the deliverance mantra and dedicate the merit. Or you can chant Amitabha Buddha's name as well, which we often chant. Or you can also chant the mantra of Guru Padmasambhava's mantra.
Om Ahom Bhaja Guru Padma Siddhi Hom. Om Ahom Bhaja Guru Padma Siddhi Hom. 念莲花生大师的咒也可以。
So it's okay if you chant Guru Padmasambhava's mantra too.
Om Amitabha Nam. Namo Amitabha Namo Amitabha Namo Amitabha Namo Amitabha Namo Amitabha Namo Namo Amitabha Namo Amitabha 我们念用唱
So you can chant or you can recite, you can sing it so that when the deceased hears it, they feel peace and until you chant until the Pure Land Trinity appears and guides them. So in the Bardo state, upon hearing the sound of the chanting, the deceased would also chant together, and then the Pure Land Trinity will appear and guide them to the Pure Land. So in order to go to Sukhavati, there are two important requirements. First, you need to have the good affinity. So what is the good affinity? It means that normally you have no bad thoughts. You have good thoughts. You do good deeds. You give. That means you have good affinity. Don't have bad thoughts. You need to have good thoughts. Then you would have good affinity. That's the first requirement. The second is to be single-mindedly chanting the Buddha's name. in full concentration, if you can stabilize, and with just one Buddha's epithet, in the Amitabha Sutra it's written that for 7 days you can chant the Buddha's name with concentration. Not scattered, then the Pure Land Sages, the Pure Land Trinity will appear. So these 2 points are very important. Therefore, we should always have good thoughts and never bad thoughts. Because if you have bad thoughts, it would be impossible to go to the Pure Land. So first, the first requirement, you have to have good affinity to go to the Pure Lands and Buddha verses. Second is that you have to be able to single-mindedly chant the Buddha's name to be reborn to the Pure Land. So if you hang this mala beads on his neck, that's also good affinity, because he has the affinity to have someone like you who chant the mantras and the Buddha's name and does that for him. So that's his good affinity, or their good affinity. The next question is from Lianhua Nini from Indonesia. Thank you, Grandmaster, for your compassion towards sentient beings. Your disciple has noticed that many non-Chinese speaking Indonesians, when they chant the mantras with the Chinese pronunciation, they do so with some difficulty and they feel unnatural. Their tongues are not very flexible, so they get tired more easily. Is it permissible for them to directly recite the mantras in Sanskrit, for example? The mantra that Guru has transmitted, can it be recited as? Same, which is Om Tarat. Exactly the same mantra. Chanting it this way would be more natural for Indonesian tongues. It is the same mantra, and there is absolutely no doubt in their hearts with regards to the root guru. They have complete faith. It is for the sake of ease for pronunciation. Will this affect the lineage? Which grandmaster health and longevity? Are you slapping on my face? Frankly speaking, the mantras that Grandmaster Chen is according to the Sanskrit too. So if you use, this is an English translation.
Mm-hmm.
So OM is OM.
T-A-R-A. T-A-R-A. Tara.
Tara. T-A-R-A.
Tara. This is T-U-T-T. A-R-A,
Tutara,
Tara, as a Soha,
and then Torah, Soha. Let me tell you, we transliterate from Sanskrit to Chinese. Sometimes there's a great discrepancy, and we chant it Soha. But do you know?
念的咒,它是沙波喝,
the Chinese way becomes 沙波喝,
沙波喝跟索哈是一样的,
so 沙波喝 came from 索哈, they're the same.
我们以前学佛的时候,
in the past, when we studied Buddhism, we chanted it as 沙波喝,
千手千眼观世音菩萨,
like the thousand-armed, thousand-eyed Avalokiteshvara, Bodhisattvas, Mahakaruna Dharani, they all with Sapoha, Sapoha. Sapo.
Ansidento. Naho. Soha. Sapo.
Incidental soha, but in Chinese they chant it as sapohe. And then later we discovered that we can just chant soha, which is closer to the Sanskrit original. But let me tell you, the pronunciation of the Indonesians is closer to Sri Lanka. What is the language there? Bali. So the pronunciation of Indonesians, or the Indonesian pronunciation, is it's really good for chanting Pali, because the language is close to Pali. And actually, when I went to India, I asked them about Sanskrit. And they told us there are 16 different kinds of Sanskrit. And the majority, just Sanskrit, there are 16 different types, and they're all different pronunciation. And one that's closer is called Pali, Pali language, which is slightly different from Sanskrit. So it would be different if you follow exactly this Indian Sanskrit, like Brahma. Or Shiva. No.
Vishnu.
Yeah. The protection god. And Shiva. You know, the Shiva is translated into Chinese as Sibo.
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 That's a pun.
Shiva.
It was Shiva. It's Shiva originally. Shiva, the god of destruction, was transliterated into Sibo in Chinese. And Brahma into Ta Fan Tian. And Vishnu. And Ganesh, which is the elephant head. Wealth deity. When Ganesh became Tibetan, it became Ganapati. Ganapati.
Ganapati. Hong Chai Shen. Ganapati.
The Red Jambala.
Ganapati.
Ganapati.
Ganesh.
Ganesh. See, different pronunciations again.
Mahasriya.
And Mahasriya.
Mahasriya,
the goddess of the auspicious, Manjushri.
Mahasriya,
in Chinese is Wunsusali, and Mahasriya, and Garuda.
Garuda,
the great golden winged bird. And Saraswati, the one holding a lute, musical instrument. And Durga. Kali. Grandmaster's pronunciation is somewhat closer. Closer to the Sanskrit. Sometimes when I chant mantras, the Adharma Buddha,
Om Adharma Tattu, Om Adharma Tattu Soha.
That's how I chant.
Om Adharma Tattu Soha. This Tattu,
Om Adharma Dattu Soha. The Indonesians would know the meaning of Dattu.
Number one.
Oh, it means number one. Anybody from Indonesia? Anyone speaking
tatu,
Indonesian?
Tatu is
satu.
Tatu. Tatu ma.
Satu.
你看我发成tatu. Tatu 我发的音是你发重音啊, tatu. 你看tatu就是第一嘛.
So satu means number one. So the pronunciation is accurate. My pronunciation is not bad.
比香港人好啦.
It's better than the Hong Kongese.
香港人在念咒啊, 你知道, 香港人念咒啊, 插那个,
when the Hong Kongese chant mantras, or even further away.
香港人念咒真的是不行的啦.
Further and further away from the Sanskrit, no good. So it's good to chant the Sanskrit directly. If they're Indonesians and they directly chant the pronunciation, that's wonderful. We chant it as. How about the Indonesians? How do you chant it? And then she asked the grandma, how can you and grandpa maintain 70 years of marriage? And the grandma smiled and said, in our era, when something breaks, we fix it. But for your generations, you change it. You throw it out and change the new one.
这个老婆呢,
so that the woman,
这个老公, 这个老婆, 那, 听到了奶奶这样子讲, 立刻就,
hearing that,
回家了, 在半路上啊,
went home, and on the way, she bought a baseball bat.
买一个鱼啊, 到那个运动器材店啊,
went to the sports thing goods, and bought an aluminium baseball bat, which many people carry in their cars or in their homes. So, aluminium baseball bat, do you know what's that for? To fix her husband. So, after fixing, then they'll have better relationship. This is a joke about old age.
老同学聚会,
yesterday, we got a reunion of classmates, old classmates. And many people came, and I couldn't remember their names, and some I don't even recognize.
岁月真的不饶人啊, 有了这么大的年纪,
time, we cannot defy time. After at this age, it's a huge difference. So felt really sad, so I just put my head down and eat. And when I checked the cell phone, there were 10 missed calls. It turned out I went into the wrong room.
This is a joke.
So that's a joke. So he went to the wrong room and he didn't recognize anyone. Now we will expound the Vimalakirti Sutra. Liberation is the place of practice as it is capable of relinquishment. What does it mean? Of course, liberation is the place of practice. Because as soon as you're liberated, then you have no more afflictions, no more worries. Now let me all of you, Is there anyone without any affliction at all?
我们在座的,
all of you present here, if you have no affliction, please raise your hand.
所有的人都有烦恼,
everyone has affliction, including Grandmaster. However, I still take it very easy, lightly.
算了吧,
whatever. It's already almost 80, it's fine. Whatever. What will be, will be. What else can I do? If I need to go, it's fine.
Take a walk.
It's about time.
Take a walk. Go home.
I'll just go,
I wanna go
take
home.
A walk and go home.
Go home to 哪里?
I want to go home. Where?
Go home. 这个叫做那个 waste very happy name.
Go home to waste very happy land.
Waste very happy country. Waste name.
West a very happy country. It's fine. I can go. Just relax. Whatever happens to my body, let it be. Just smile. That's liberation. You have nothing in your heart and mind. That's liberation. So what does it mean? You have nothing on your mind or heart, that means you have no afflictions. You have no worries for your parents and also not for your children and not for your grandchildren. There's no concerns for anything, no worries. What are you worried about? The children and grandchildren, they have their own destinies. And why are you worried about your parents? Of course, you need to be filial to them. And you love your children and grandchildren. But if you cannot control them, then just let it go. Let it be. Jesus has said in the Mark, the Gospel of Mark, the four Gospels, Mark, Matthew. I cannot say in Chinese, but in Taiwanese.
Mark, Matthew, Luca, John.
Lucas and John. The four Gospels. Mark, Matthew, Lucas, and John. In the Gospel of Mark, Jesus stated, if you love your parents more than you love me, then you're not my disciple. If you love your children more than you love me, then you're not my disciple. So you need to place Jesus on the first place, because Jesus can bring you to the heavens. Guru Padmasambhava also said so too. On my path, it's the same as the snake climbing on a bamboo. Either you go up, else you would go down. So what this means is, you need to place the biggest issue of your life about life and death, and to have attainment to become Buddhas and Bodhisattvas as top priority first and foremost. And parents and children are second. Jesus stated that if you love your parents more than you love me, then you're not a Jesus follower. That's what he said. In the Gospel of Mark, it's written there.
这里谈到的,
so it talks about here, liberation is a place of practice, which means you're free from any cares and concerns. You have no affliction whatsoever. Can you do that? So in order to be liberated, you have to be free from all cares and afflictions. So all the small things, they're all nothing. They're all small things. And the real big thing is liberation. So therefore, about my own body, in old age, it's unavoidable that some parts of your body or organs starting to deteriorate or to break down or have illnesses. It's old age and being sick are going together. So you need to put down or let go this ailing body or sick body. Sakyamuni Buddha left at 80, and Grandmaster is reaching 80 in a few months. So the same as Sakyamuni Buddha, what are you worried about? Nothing to worry about. Let's just sing a song. Then that's liberation, right? So you don't regard the illness you have as an illness. The same mentally. I just let it go. The same for the body. Just let it go. And parents even let go long ago, and children too. So why worry about grandchildren? Just let them go. So what are you worried about? That's liberation. So being liberated, you can do that. Skillful means at the place of practice as they teach and transform sentient beings. As a Buddhist, we just go with the flow. Very simple. You go with the flow with the sentient beings in order to deliver sentient beings. So whatever suffering sentient being has, you follow them. You go with them and you exchange places with them. You put yourself in their shoes. If someone suffers and you think it's unrelated, and then you exchange place, and then you would know what kind of suffering they suffer. And then you need to teach them how to be liberated from the suffering, and that is called delivering sentient beings. And that is also called giving. So skillful means are the place of practice as they teach and transform sentient beings. So you need to go with the flow and to deliver them with skillful means. The four ways of enticements are the place of practice. So a step further from the skillful means are called the four ways of enticements. The first one is giving. You need to give to sentient beings. So not receiving, you need to give instead to sentient beings. Second is you perform beneficial things to the sentient beings. So you need to do things that benefit sentient beings. And third, it's association, which means you get close to them, and to be exactly the same as they are. And that's called likeness association. So whatever they get, you also get. So you're on the same boat. And you use this method to deliver sentient beings. And the fourth is loving, gentle and kind words and language to touch them. That's the four ways of enticements, four methods to deliver sentient beings. So the four ways of enticements are the place of practice as they can attract and deliver all sentient beings. So therefore Vimalakirti went to the gambling parlor and delivered those in the parlor and went to the brothels to deliver those in the brothels. So that's likeness association. I went there, like Grandmaster Lu also had the witness. I went to the dance halls, and then the musician in the dance hall now followed me and became ordained to become Reverend Lian Yi from Taiwan, right? In the past, when I visited the dance halls in Taichung, he was the one playing
Odara,
oboe, maybe? And he was a musician and he watched me dance and he noticed that that person danced differently. I always maintain a distance with the dance companions. You can ask Lian Yi Fa Si. I never dance the dance where you hug each other completely glued together in the dark when the lights are darkened. Like 3, 4, 5 full glue, like silent pass. I don't dance such a dance. I dance a very standard, like Jia Xin. I'd rather like tango. And I delivered many of the dance girls too. And also one prostitute. And the a Dharma name is Lian Bai, living in Kaohsiung. She was a prostitute. But I didn't go to the brothel. But to the dance halls. In the past, I danced at Nanyue, Xiaoye Qi,
Yidu,
Baixue. And the boss at the Baixue, or White Snow Dance Hall, I consulted him for his office and his desk. For the feng shui. So four dance halls there, dance clubs. And I know them all. I live in Kaohsiung and Taichung. And then later on, there was also Dongfang. And then afterward, they all closed down. Now only Baixue or White Snow left. Have you been there?
你有去过?
You did?
还有那个
I think I brought someone there. Where's the elders? Where are the elders?
我们长老有没有来？长治没有啊？
长治
带他去过耶都会。
It's not here. I brought him to 耶都会 to the dance club.
然后我们两个带着两个舞女啊出去吃宵夜。
And we brought two dance girls for a late night supper.
带两个舞女出去吃宵夜。啊，吃宵夜的时候啊。
And then during supper,
那个卖那个卖面的那个人问我
，At the noodle seller asked us, where are you from?
我们从下雪的地方来。
We came from a snowy place, because Seattle was snowing at that time.
变笑哎，什么下雪
？And they said, Are you kidding?
不知道我们是刚下飞机了，我带长治去一下。
So they didn't know that.We just got off the plane. I just wanted to let Chang Zi, Master Chang Zi, to just so that he knows, because he's a very honest person. So I brought him once. That's likeness association. We went there to deliver sentient beings. Do you know?We took the dance girls out and then taught them Buddha Dharma. And Vimalakirti knew about it. So four ways of enticements are the place of practice as they attract and entice sentient beings and deliver them. So you cannot say, oh, I cannot go to the dance halls. I cannot go to the nightclubs. You know, but we needed to go there to deliver them. I did many. Someone by the name Xiao Hui. Someone called Xiu Xiu.
小
咪
一个叫小芳的，
跟小芳，
度了几个都皈依生活中。
So I delivered them and they took refuge into the school. Really,
我还记得他们的名字呢。
I even remember their names.
到现在还记得。
Until now.
但是比较接近的我就忘掉了。
But recent events I forget.
四色是道场，色众生故。
So the four ways of enticements are the place of practice as they attract and entice sentient beings. Okay, it's getting late. So according to Vimalakirti, as long as you have clear light radiance, and then you can go anywhere, that's according to Vimalakirti.
但是你如果没有光明心
But if you don't have clear light radiance in your heart, then you cannot go anywhere. That's violating the precepts. Om Mani Padme Hum.